before we start, I will be discussing with you guys a link on the website, a website link, clarifying the concept of proportion. प्रोपोर्शन बेसिकली किसको बोलते हैं? प्रोपोर्शन किसी भी दो चीज़ों के दरमियान कनेक्शन को बोलते हैं, रिलेशन को बोलते हैं. इफ़ आई गिव यू एन एग्जांपल, हमारे आसपास बहुत सारी चीज़ें होती हैं जो आपस में कनेक्टेड होती हैं. अगर मैं आप एग्जांपल दूँ, लेट्स सपोज वी टेक एन एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस डॉग. एज द एज ऑफ द डॉग इंक्रीजेस, इसकी हाइट बढ़ती रहेगी. एज द एज ऑफ द डॉग इंक्रीजेस, the weight of the dog will also increase. If you see over here, दो चीज़ें आपस में यहाँ पर connected हैं. One, the age of the dog, and the other thing is the height or the weight of the dog. So if you see that, if the age is increasing, so the height is increasing, and so the weight is increasing. So if you see over here, these two things are having a connection between them. So we call it proportional. Proportional or proportionality, we just use these two words to show that two things have relation between themselves. So now, proportionality has two types. One is direct proportion and the other is inverse proportion. So in this video, we'll be looking carefully at what is direct proportion. As I give you an example over here, कि यहाँ पे अगर age increase करती है dog की, तो उसकी हाइट भी इंक्रीज़ करेगी और उसका वेट भी इंक्रीज़ करेगा. तो अगर यहाँ पे देखा जाए, इफ यू सी ओवर हियर, व्हेन द एज इज़ इंक्रीजिंग द हाइट इज़ आल्सो इंक्रीजिंग, व्हेन द एज ऑफ द डॉग इज़ इंक्रीजिंग द वेट ऑफ द डॉग इज़ आल्सो इंक्रीजिंग. इफ यू सी ओवर हियर, जब एक चीज़ यहाँ पे बढ़ रही है तो दूसरी चीज़ भी बढ़ रही है. सो इन सच सिनेरियोस, व्हेन बोथ द थिंग्स इंक्रीज टुगेदर और डिक्रीज टुगेदर, दोनों चीज़ें जब एक साथ बढ़ती हैं या एक साथ कम होती हैं, सो वी कॉल दैट रिलेशन एज डायरेक्ट प्रोपोर्शन. सो यू सी ओवर हियर, डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शन इज एज वन अमाउंट इंक्रीजेस, अनदर अमाउंट आल्सो इंक्रीजेस एट द सेम टाइम. सो जस्ट पॉज द वीडियो फॉर अ मिनट एंड थिंक ऑफ डिफरेंट एग्जांपल्स ऑफ डायरेक्ट प्रोपोर्शन अराउंड. So I hope you guys have done it. So if I give you examples of proportionality, let me give an example of buying material. For example, you have a money, you have some money in your pocket and you want to buy some material. You went to a supermarket and now you are standing in front of the store, in front of the shelf to buy something. Now, the more things you put in the trolley, the more you will have to pay. For example, if you're going to buy 5 packets of chips, so you know that one pack is for, let's suppose that one pack is for rupees 10. So if you want to buy 5 packets, how much will you have to pay? That's really obvious that you will have to pay rupees 50. And so if you buy 10 packets, then you will have to pay 100 rupees. So the more you buy, the more you will have to pay. Let's suppose if I'm buying only 2 packets, then I have to pay 20 rupees. If I'm buying only 1 packet, I have to pay only rupees 10. So the less I'm buying, the less I will have to pay. So if you see that, the number of packets and the price both increase together. If the number of packets increase, their amount or their cost also increases. If the number of packets decrease, then the amount also decreases. So if you see over here, these two things increase or decrease together. So we call such kind of relationship as directly proportional. So if you see over here, whenever we need to show direct proportional, we use this symbol. Now you have to be very careful. As you will be learning maths, you will be coming across different kinds of symbol, and one of the symbol will be the symbol for infinity. If I recall it to you, we use it in sets. Infinity is something which has no ending. If I talk about numbers, numbers have no ending. You keep on increasing numbers and they will increase forever. For example, if you talk about sand, you cannot count sand. So the sand particles are, there are a lot of sand particles. There are infinity sand particles. if you talk about stars, you are not able to count the stars because there are many stars. There are some stars even which the scientists haven't discovered. So there are some things which have no ending, which are not concise in a number. So we represent such things as infinity, and the symbol for infinity is 8 in a horizontal position. So you have to be very careful that you're not going to mix up the symbol of infinity with the symbol of directly proportional. Let's talk about a different example. Let's suppose you're working somewhere. So if you see over here, how much you earn is directly proportional to how many hours you work. The more you work, the more you get paid. So for example, if you're going to do a job which pays you $20 per hour, so if you're going to work for 1 hour, you're getting paid $20. If you're going to work for 2 hours, then you're going to pay $20 plus $20, you're going to be paid $40. So the more you're going to work, the more you will be paid. The less you work, the less you will be paid. So if you see over here, the number of hours and the amount or the money you get or the pay you get increases together. The more you work, the more you get paid. The less you work, the less you get paid. So this is something which we say or which we relate as directly proportional. I'm going to read the example from an O-level Oxford book, and I would just say that books are really, really important. Whichever syllabus you're going to follow, make sure you're going to follow the books, because if you're familiar with the book you're using, you will be familiar with the paper you're going to get, because papers are made from the book. So I could have used a slide over here, but I haven't used it because books are really, really important. So I'm going to relate this from a Singaporean book, that's an Oxford Mathematics book, 7th edition. So here they give an example of a library. So let's suppose you have borrowed a book, and everyone knows that when you're going to borrow a book, you have a week to read the book. So the library will issue you a book for a week, and after a week you have to return the book. There are some rules in often some libraries that if you're going to give the book back late after a week, you have to pay some fine. So over here, if you're giving the book 1 day late, so you're getting a 15 cents fine. If you're going to give your book back 2 days late, you're going to pay 30 cents. And this increases as the number of days increases. If you see over here, as the number of days increases, the fine also increases. If you see over here, the number of days are increasing from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5. And same over here, the amount is also increasing. The more late you give, the more you have to pay. So 15, 30, 30, 45. So you can see over here, the amount is also increasing. If you go back this way, as the number of days decrease, the amount also decreases. You can read the statement over here. From the investigation, you can notice that the number of days, that is, they have represented by a letter. They have represented by a letter, that is an X over here. Number of days are represented by a letter X. A book is overdue increases, that is the fine, which they have also again represented by letter Y, increases proportionally. If X is double, then the Y will also be double. If the X is triple, and so the Y is. So I hope it's very clear. Such kind of relationship is known as direct proportion, and we say that fine Y cent is directly proportional to the number of days. जब दो चीज़ों के दरमियान आप देखते हैं कि अगर एक चीज़ बढ़ रही है दूसरी चीज़ भी बढ़ेगी, यू से दैट दीज टू थिंग्स आर डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वन अनदर. नाउ इन द सेकेंड पार्ट आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग यू गाइस हाउ टू राइट स्टेटमेंट्स फॉर डायरेक्ट प्रोपोर्शन.